These videos are presented to the media as an evidence of New People's Army blatant recruitment in schools through their legal fronts, claiming that they are merely progressive organizations. One video was recovered at the blast site of the surgical strike in summer last October 26, 2019. This video clearly identified and discovered the personalities among of whom are Francis Ern Mariveles and Karen May Diaz, both from PUP Santa Mesa, and a certain Eilish Castro, who's confirmed to be taking up political science at the University of Santo Tomas. They were all initially members of Anak Bayan, League of Filipino Students, Kabataan Party List, etc. while they were still in school.
NPA ako.
Another video recovered in an encounter site in Quezon Province in 2006 features the training of NPAs who were later identified as a former student members of progressive groups. One of those in the video is Alexandria Pacalda, who was jailed after her arrest last September 14, 2018. The other is a certain Ivan Cortez Zuniga, a BS forestry student from UP Los Baños, who became the University Student Council vice chairperson. Other personalities are still to be identified. The third video was recovered last December 5 during a law enforcement operation in Antipolo City that led to the neutralization of alias Patroman, the leader of a sub-regional military Area 4A. Winilyn Gromeo was shown in the video and was positively identified by her mother, Miss Jacqueline Mendoza Gromeo. Miss Jacqueline is one of the mothers from the Hands of Our Children movement.
Sa hinabahaba ng panahon, 3 taong ka nang nawawala sa pamilya natin.
The scheme for NPA recruitment in schools begin by using activism to radicalize the student using common societal issues. Slowly, they are being immersed in the organization where they are taught, persuaded, and agitated, leading to join the armed revolution. The videos, together with the reports of students who died as NPAs in encounters, showed that the scheme is obviously alive inside the halls of our academic institution, despite the belief, as parents, their children will have a bright future. Are we to let our children fall in the wrong hands that will ruin their future?